60 seconds away from bringing down the Greenfield Bridge. So after 100 plus years, Sally's going to hit the button and the bridge is going to come down. And the anticipation and more than 20 years of planning to replace this bridge will be underway. Of course, the construction of the new bridge will get started as soon as they get the debris out of the way. And then after that, they'll start the foundation work for the new bridge, and it should be open in the spring of 2017. So it won't be soon. It will be, but it will be coming very quickly. We now have one of the folks from KESCO who's here, who's going to give Sally the word of when to actually push it. And as they're doing the countdown, I'll bring the mic over so that you can hear. Here it comes.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fire in the hole.
Well, there you saw it. You saw it come down. Tom Press from KESCO, who's the company that brought it down. Just watching it come down, what's your reaction to how it went?
Looked like it all went well. Everything looks like before. It's hard to tell with all the dust, but we're going to go in and inspect that. Again, we have computer-controlled detonators, which will check that to verify that they all are fired, but we'll still do a visual check after that.
And as far as the way it collapsed and the way it came down?
It looked perfect.
Those are the words you want to hear.
Exactly right.
It looked perfect.
Yep.
Thank you very much, Tom. I appreciate that.
John, we could hear that over the air.
Real quick. Could you?
We could hear that as
pretty incredible.
The word perfect came out as we were watching that. And you said just a few seconds, it seemed even shorter than that, and it did seem to go exactly as described from the center all the way out to the ends, and then that middle caving in, and look at all that dust. I know what it sounded like listening to it on TV. What did it sound like? What did you feel being right there?
Oh, that was pretty cool hearing it happen. And Sally, you pushed the plunger. Was it what you expected it?
It wasn't as loud as I thought it was going to be. But I was
disappointed.
It was fun. I'm going to do it again.
I think you've already done it. Only one time per customer to bring down the bridge. But what did you feel? How did you feel?
Exciting.
Now let's build a new bridge. As far as the concussion and that kind of stuff, you can feel it a little bit here, but now that the dust is clearing, let's take a look at what's left. We've got a lot of steel stacked up on top, Jen, and as you can see, the lower bridge, the bridge at the bottom that was has been catching the debris, collapsed along with the Greenfield Bridge. They both came down together. That's not completely unexpected. But, and actually, it's what they thought might happen, because the supports on that bridge were not as strong as if you were building a bridge for a highway. But you can see the steel up on top. The bridge itself, the small bridge at the bottom, is also made of steel. They have to cut all that up. They've got a line of dumpsters here on the parkway that they're going to be putting the steel in to haul it out of here. And once they can get that steel out of the way and then get the concrete, they're actually going to store the concrete on site initially, off to the side. And they get the concrete out of the way, get the dirt out of the way, and within a couple of days, get the road reopened. But it certainly looked like, and as you heard, he said it looked perfect. It looked like a textbook implosion of that bridge. It came down exactly the way they described to me that it would. And now they just have to get in there and clean it up, Jim.
I imagine for some people watching, it's a little sad. This is a piece of history. You can't have driven the parkway.